cold air comes in, humidity at 92%, and now it's going to be puddles to beautiful skating rinks all over town. We'll be below freezing, I think, from now probably until Monday afternoon. Low temperature tonight of about 23, and not much blowing or blowing up in the sky, and certainly I don't expect any snow tonight. Now comes tomorrow. I'm predicting that sometime in the afternoon, maybe late, but let's say around 2 to 4, we will start a little snow. And by tomorrow night, it should get a little bit heavy. And by tomorrow midnight, it'll get quite heavy. And we'll have a high tomorrow of about 32 on a northeast wind that will get strong and gusty as the snow begins. And Sunday, I'm predicting it will snow all day long. And it'll be a very heavy snowfall. And that Monday the sun will come out, and maybe we'll get up to 35 in the wake of that snow. But I'm thinking that travel will be somewhere between poor and impossible on Sunday in Illinois, Indiana, Michigan, and southern Wisconsin, which will all be in the heart of this big snow area. Tim, that's just a forecast. It's not a promise. It's not a guarantee. I have some good, strong evidence to support it, however.
Well, that's generally the way you present things. You never guarantee them, but you're always pretty accurate, aren't you?
I am always pretty, no, I am usually pretty accurate. Sometimes I do something really dumb, don't I, Fahey?
Like predicting snow. I hope.
Oh, I'm just stroking you anyway, John. But let's talk about the Cubs, because the bleacher bums are no longer going to be able to cheer 1-0, 2-0, 3-0. Manny's been traded to the Philadelphia Phillies, and here's what the Cubs get for Manny. Catcher Barry Foote, who hit only 158 last year in 39 games, but he'll be the Cubs' first-string catcher. Center fielder Jerry Martin, a 271 hitter, who will also start for the Cubs. They also get second baseman Ted Sizemore and a pair of minor league pitchers. To get all this, the Cubs give up Trillo, a 270 hitter and a good fielder. They also give the Phillies catcher Dave Rader and center fielder Greg Gross, who should be a tough out on the Phillies AstroTurf Veterans Stadium infield.